What's up? Today, I'm going to be unboxing and sharing my first impressions of the new Godox Lux Junior and Lux Senior Retro Flashes. Thanks so much to my friends over at Godox for sending this over for me to try out. Let's get into it. First, let's unbox the Lux Junior. As you might have guessed by the name, the Lux Junior is the smaller of the two flashes. On the left side of the flash is a sync cable port. On the back are the dials for manual or auto mode, as well as the power adjust dial and meter panel. On the right side of the flash is the optical control switch that you can use when you want to use this as a secondary flash. The top of the flash has this nice textured pattern, as well as the recycle indicator slash test button and the optical control sensor. Underneath the flash, you'll find the battery compartment that holds two AAA batteries. Inside the box, we also have a nice velvety carrying bag, a sync cable, and the instruction manual. Now, let's check out the Lux Senior. This flash has a folded design. On the outside, it has the same textured pattern as the Lux Junior. And on the right side, there's a sync cable port as well as a USB-C port for charging. The control switches of this flash are all located on the back. And now, here's a demonstration of how to open and close the flash. Remember to push the red button to pop out the flash bulb before using it, and to push the bulb back in before folding the Lux Senior back up. And inside this box, you'll find a USB-C cable for charging, a sync cable, a carrying bag, and the instruction manual. And now here are some example photos that I took using the Lux Junior and the Lux Senior. I took some test shots with Aaron to showcase what the flashes look like in the shade on a sunny day. The first image is with no flash, and clearly Aaron is very underexposed. This next image was taken with the Lux Junior, and now we can actually see Aaron. The last photo was taken with the Lux Senior with very similar results. I took a few more photos with direct sunlight hitting the side of Aaron's face. Once again, the first image is without a flash, and we can't see any features on his face. And the next one is with the Lux Junior, and this last photo is with the Senior. Here are all three images in both scenarios side by side for better comparison. Looking back, I realized that the photos using flash are so similar because I set both flashes to the same setting to achieve a similar exposure. So I went ahead and made sure that I had a couple other examples to show. This next example is in a studio style setup with the Lux Senior set up with an umbrella and the Junior on a light stand pointing at the backdrop to achieve an infinite white background. I took some nice portraits of my brother Kenny, and I was super impressed with the power of these flashes, especially the Lux Senior. Even after bouncing it off of an umbrella, it was still nice and bright and it illuminated the subject really nicely. I was able to get them both to fire off camera by setting them to S1 and using my in-camera flash to trigger them. I think that these two flashes together are perfect if you're looking for a simple but extremely effective setup. And finally, here are some examples of using the Lux Junior outdoors at night. I love to go out and shoot more at night with this flash. There's so many creative ways to use a flash for night portraits. And yeah, that's all I have for my first impressions. If you have any questions at all, feel free to ask me in the comments and I'll get back to you. Thank you so much again to Godox for letting me try these out. I can't wait to keep using these in the future. And thank you for watching. I will see you guys next time.